everybody. I am the Mademoiselle and this is my channel, and today we are going to be reacting to some nonsense. Okay, so apparently this girl gets kicked out her house for being a thot and the police are called. Some new parenting shits I ain't never heard of that just done come about lately, and I need to know, you know, because you know I'm gonna be a parent soon. I need to know what to do to my kids as well. So before we get into this video, make sure you smash that subscribe button, smash that like button, smash everybody you know that can help a sister out on the road to 500k, posting Monday through Friday until we get there. Make sure you cop your merchandise. Everything is down in the description box below, and make sure you follow me on Instagram because YouTube does not like to notify you guys when I post a video. So comment down below, have you ever been kicked out of your house? If so, for how long, and what exactly happened when you were kicked out? Why were you kicked out? Did you come back into the house? Did this ruin your relationship with your parents? Because I have a lot of friends that it completely destroyed their relationship with their parents and changed their lives wholeheartedly because they were kicked out of their house at a very young age.
I don't want you, because that's how supervisors act. You're not helping him by acting this way. This is a mother-daughter incident. Mama, no, I did not tell you to come in my house. I did not tell you to come in my house. You making my daughter gonna continue to disrespect. You see what's finna happen? You see what's finna happen? This man don't know you, but he looking at your fine ass, and he back and talk to you later. That's what he looking at, because if he was a man, and he got a mama, and he respects his mama, he wouldn't treat me like this right now, because you don't know what's going on. But you looking at my sexy ass daughter, and you judging me. That's what you doing.
Wait, what?
Now, I need your supervisor, because you don't push my door. That's illegal. Let me tell you something. If you move, you let him disrespect me, but you don't. Sir, could you call for another officer? I'm asking you, please. Okay, go get...
He's the supervisor.
Okay, get somebody over him. I'm not stupid. I'm not... If you move, because this man told you and I birthed you, you fucking him. You fucking him.
Wait, what? What? Okay. So, first things first, shout out to Organic the Maze Runner. This is his original video. I guess this is a commentary about it, but I'm just gonna react to the clip. Second of all, it seems to me that she kicked her daughter out and her daughter's trying to come back in the house to get her shit, and her mother is not having it. The cops have been called. They're trying to get her stuff. And I'm just appalled by what her reaction is to the cops. Like, yeah, the cops shouldn't be able to come into your house and shouldn't be pushing your door and all of that, but all the girl is trying to do is get her stuff so she can leave. I think she's being a tad bit extra, but maybe there's more to the story.
You could talk to me yourself without these motherfuckers coming over here. You know what the end result of this shit with these police and shit, because they don't care about nobody. They don't have no feelings. They get paid and they come with their attitude. They come with that goddamn attitude too, because that's what they get paid to do. This is a family matter. And he got his hand on my goddamn door telling me I can't close my goddamn door. This my door. I need Caesar if she move, because another man that didn't birth you tell you to move. Girl, me, you, and these cops. I'm not playing. Don't you dare disrespect me like that. Give you your stuff. You don't need them to get your stuff. You just trying to prove a sorry ass fucking point, because you went out and had you a little good little time last night. Did you enjoy that? This man don't even know what the fuck you did, but he judged me. That's what I can't stand about black people. That's what I can't stand about black people. You got your foot in my door knowing that's illegal. You know that's illegal. You can't.
You might go get herself.
I'll get her stuff, but don't tell me when I'm gonna go get it, because I birthed her and you one day. You didn't help me raise this child, so you can't tell me what the hell to do about it. I'm in my house. I am in my house. Y'all disrespect me. Dude got his fucking feet in my shit. He got his fucking feet blocking me from closing my door. If I was to close my door on this man, if I would get to her stuff and she know, but if I was to close my door on him, y'all just want a reason to do something to me. Y'all want a reason to take me to jail. And this motherfucker right here, I don't understand. You not that my door. No, this motherfucker.
attitude. Baby, I'm recording this. He came with an attitude. Nigga, you can smile all you want. He came with an attitude. He came with it. That's funny. This is a civil. This is something going on with a mother and a daughter. That's funny to you. You don't need to be a police. You don't need to be a goddamn police. If you think this is funny, you got kids. You got a daughter. You done been through some shit with your kids. Don't judge me. You don't know what I do for my motherfucking kids. Spitz got his foot in my door.
Just hush. Just
okay.
Hush, Kyle. Just hush.
I'm finna close. Call y'all the supervisor, because I'm finna close my motherfucking door. You don't get your motherfucking foot out my door, I'm gonna break it. I don't give a fuck. He ain't got the right to stick his foot in my door. And he know it. But you feel like because you black and got a badge on, you can do that fucking shit.
All right. There's just way too much going on. Okay, so what I picked up on is the fact that this girl was out late, I'm guessing, fucking and sucking, or maybe she just was out late chilling with her friends. She could have been doing anything. No one knows. Didn't come home. And I've had a lot of friends this has happened to, like a lot, where, you know, you have a curfew, you don't follow the curfew, you don't come home when you're supposed to, and your parents are like, you know what, don't come the fuck back. I'm guessing this girl was very afraid of her mother, okay? And she didn't want to come back by herself because she knew her mother was probably gonna try to beat her ass or whatever, because you know how that's how a lot of parents are. You know, you leave a house or you come home late or you don't come until the next day, you better not show your face back in the house the next day because you might get your ass beat. So I'm guessing she brought the police there as a precaution because she know how crazy her mother is. And just based off the way she's acting, her persona, her aura, her energy that she's giving off, you can absolutely tell that she was probably terrified to go in there by herself. And honestly, I'd be terrified to go in there by myself just by the way she's acting, because she's doing way too much, acting all types of insane. Like, she don't need to be acting like that. It's really not that serious. This is just my opinion. This is based off an assumption. I'm not saying this is exactly what happened, but just based off the context of the conversation, I believe that is what's happening. Also, I don't like the fact that she's just antagonizing the cops. Like, yeah, the cops shouldn't have your foot in the door and be pushing your door wide open. I really don't think that is legal at all. But they just trying to get the girl stuff. You're doing all this hoopling and hollering and talking. All you gotta do is go get the girl stuff so they can go. It's really not that serious. This is how problems end up escalating, okay? This doesn't need to be that deep. Give the little girl her stuff so she can bounce.
Holding my motherfucking door open and shit like that, fam. You ain't got to tell her shit. You ain't got to tell her shit. Kaya, get in your car with your sister, cause this ain't gonna be good. If I was you, if you love your mama, these motherfuckers don't care nothing about me. If I was you, go and we'll talk later. This family. Don't involve these motherfuckers. They don't give a damn. This motherfucker laughing. This motherfucking nigga up here with his foot in my door. Go with your sister and we'll talk about this later. You hear me? You hear me? You hear me, baby? Go do what I said do. Go do what I said do. Now, hey man, you heard what I told my baby. Go ahead and do what your mama said do. This man, unless you fucking my baby, go and do what I said do, baby. We'll settle this. We'll settle this. He's doing too much. This ain't even his job. You don't get paid enough for this fuck shit, man.
Okay, the fact that she keeps alluding to the fact that, oh, well, you see my sexy ass daughter, oh, you fucking my daughter, that is horrible. These are grown ass men, they're also officers. Just the fact that you would think that they fucking your daughter is sick. Not only the fact that this girl looks mad young, she can't be older than like 14, 15 max. There's no reason you should be referring to your daughter as sexy in front of these grown ass cops. Alluding to the fact they're touching her or harassing her sexually or anything like that. That's just sick. That's really, really disturbing. Like, to say the least, very disturbing.
I'm in my house. I got rights in my house. You don't stick your foot in my door. If somebody stick their foot in your door, you'll shoot the shit out of them. You'll shoot the shit out of them. Don't try me, fuck.
She right.
I don't even play that shit, man. That's my dog. Get you some kids. Get you some teenagers and let them disrespect you.
I don't even know who to feel bad for in this type of situation, because I feel like everyone is just in the wrong. I feel like the mother's doing way too much. She should have just got her daughter stuff, gave it to her and let her leave since she kicked her out in the first place. I feel like the daughter shouldn't have been out doing whatever the hell she was doing in the first place. And I feel like the cop should have been a little bit more understanding and not had their foot and hand in the woman's door, okay? Everyone's wrong in this situation. This is absolutely not okay. And I feel like this could have probably ended out really bad. Like, this could have been a very terrible situation. But if I'm, like, I don't know, just based off assumption again, I can assume this is like one of those single mothers. I can tell she's probably a single mother, and if she's not a single mother, I can tell the dad probably just either isn't there or doesn't care about this type of situation. And I feel like a lot of these situations do occur in these types of households where it's like a single parent household, whether it's a single mother or a single father. It's very hard to take on one kid alone, especially a teenager. Teenagers are very difficult to deal with. So honestly, this is just sad. I hope she got back in the house. I hope she got her stuff if she didn't get back in the house. I hope nothing bad happened to her. I hope the cops didn't sexually harass her or whatever, was trying to get her or whatever the mother was alluding to. I feel like all of her, everything that she was saying was completely out of line. I don't feel like the cops were having sex with the child or thought that she was attractive and that's why they were trying to help her. I feel like the mother was completely out of line when it came to trying to identify exactly why the cops were there and trying to identify the reasoning for their visit. I feel like they literally were there just to help her get her stuff, and she was probably afraid to go there alone after what she had done the night before, whatever it is that she did the night before. Let me know what you think about this situation down in the comment section below. Do you think that the mother was right for reacting the way she acted and they could have just handled this alone? Do you think that the daughter was just afraid, that's why she brought the cops with her to get her stuff? Do you feel like the cops were justified in just, you know, holding her door open? Because, you know, cops are real assholes. Some cops are really assholes, and that could have been a lot worse than it really was. But let me know your position with all three of these people in the situation. Well, four, because I don't know, I feel like everyone was wrong in some aspect. Honestly, I've had a lot of friends who have been kicked out of their house by their parents for doing thought stuff or just not coming home, running away, stuff like that. And I think a lot of us need to understand, especially black parents, y'all need to understand, when you kick your kid out, you're basically giving your kid an invitation to be ain't shit. You're giving your kids an invitation to be raised by the streets. At this point, all bets are off. They can do whatever they want, go wherever they want, be with whoever they want, and it's gonna be hard to bring them back from that. And you're also bringing them, and you're also putting them in an environment where something horrible can happen to them. They can be kidnapped, they can be sex trafficked, they can be raped, they can be assaulted, they can be robbed, they can be taken advantage of. So many things can happen to your kid when you sit there and you kick them out in the street. And I know there's a lot of people that's probably watching this like, oh nah, but if she acting like that, she grown. Oh, she acting like that, she can handle what's out there. She can handle what's out there, she acting like that.
If she acting like that, that means she thinks she grown.
She shouldn't be acting like that under my roof. I completely understand it, but at the same time, this toxic mentality has to stop. You need to stop treating your kids like they're adults. Yes, a lot of kids like to do adult shit, like have sex and do drugs and go out and join gangs and whatever, but that doesn't make them an adult. That makes them a misguided child. And as a parent, you as a parent, it is your job to make sure that they are guided in the right direction, even when they fall off. Okay, you can do anything in the world, everything in the world, to make sure your kid turns out great, to make sure your kid is on a straight and arrow. However, sometimes they do fall off. Now, when they do fall off, the worst thing you can ever do is to push them out of your house. The worst thing you can do is to kick them out into the streets, push them into the arms of another person, push them out into the world of the unknown, because you never know what can happen to them. Now, God forbid you kick the kid out, now she gets beaten and raped and thrown into the motherfucking woods. Now you on the hook for child endangerment. Like, come on now. Y'all need to think, okay? We need to do better, guys. As a people, we need to do better. This is absolutely unacceptable. I've seen too many of my friends get kicked out by their parents, and it's never been a good situation. So let me know down in the comment section below, what would you do in this particular situation? Make sure you like, share, subscribe, do all that. Follow me on social media, and I'm gonna see y'all next time.